Welcome everybody. I made a video today. The weather's kind of crabby out here and it's raining. Fixing to turn windy and cold. So I thought I'd make a video on just how to clean all these old shotgun hulls that I've been finding around and you've been seeing on these videos. So if you ever want to collect them, I know that they say they ain't worth nothing, but if you just the pleasure of getting out and finding them and just finding some history. That's what it's all about. Well, anyway, how I've been cleaning them, there's a block of wood. It's just a 2x2. And I just been, what this is just something to hold them and clean them with, because you can't hardly hold these in your finger and do this. It's kind of hard. So I'll just go through how I've done it. Well, anyway, it's just a block of wood, 2x2. And after I cut the holes in it, I put it in a vise. Now, you don't have a vise, you could just take a big 2x6 or whatever and drill these holes in them and have something just to sit down on a table or something and just clean them. But anyway, what I done for a 12 gauge, it's a 13/16 for a 12 gauge hole. 3/4 a 16 gauge. And 11/16 is for a 20 gauge. Now, I ain't got one for a 410 gauge. They're very rare, but I have found a couple. But anyway, what you need as far as tools, you need some old rough scissors. Nothing special, nothing expensive, just some heavy-duty old scissors. A brush, a little brush brush, a regular steel brush, a little bit bigger brush brush, is all these is. And here's a little saw. Sometimes you run into the newer shotgun shells. They're not really new, but they're not really old either. They've got plastic still on them. So to mount them, the boards you want to mount them in or present them, you want to cut that plastic off. And this file is just, if you find some real bad places on them, just to touch them up a little bit. So, and then I've got these little bitty things here for cleaning you can stick in a drill. And it makes it a little bit handy if it's really, really nasty. And you can get these at any Harbor Freight, any of this stuff, the scissors, the little brushes, these brushes, this. You can get any of this if you did. It's not expensive at all. All right, what I usually do to clean them is you take here like a 12 gauge. You see the back of them, and this is just an old piece of a coat hanger. Usually just clean out all the dirt you can out of them. You see the dirt coming out of it. There ain't much left to them. Sometimes they got pretty good paper in them, sometimes they don't. But you see how rough these is? So they're about rotted away. I usually take these scissors and cut around. Just cut around them where they're kind of even all the way around. Still raggedy. Like that. Now, what I usually do is just take an old regular steel brush and clean around the sides of them. You're not going to get them perfect, but you get them dirt off of them. So that's good enough, because you won't see that once you stick it in your board or whatever. So you stick this in the 12 gauge slot you got there. Now you can take this, your little, they do a lot better than instead of a steel brush. You could do it with a steel brush to get some of the big stuff off. But then I would advise to go into a brass brush, because I about wore this one out. You go to a brass brush and you just do a circular motion. Get down in the cracks and the lettering on it and the grooves. You just keep doing that. And you'll notice it starts shining up. Some of them don't, but a lot of them do, because the real old ones, they've got better brass in them than the new ones, and they'll last a long time where the new ones are just rot away. You can see how I've done that. And if you prefer, you can take this, polish it a little bit, instead of doing all that hand scrubbing. And I'll show you the results of this. This is a 12 gauge Winchester repeater. If it'll focus. Okay, so we've got that one pretty good. Now we've got a note in here that we found. It's a 16 gauge. You get it going to 16 gauge hole, and that was a 3/4. So we take our steel brush, we just clean it off a little bit, get the roughest off. Then we go to the brass for the polish. It seems like the brass fits a lot better. Some of them get pretty bad shape to where you just have to put the drill on it, really polish them, because see, the more you polish it, it just keeps going away. The steel brush won't do that. It'll make it a dull color. It's brass on brass, I guess. And you see that? That looks pretty good. You see that one? We'll try another one here. We've got another 12 gauge here. And you can see how dull they look before you do anything. See how nasty they are. You barely can't read them out in the field for sure. You have to clean them up. Well, you can get this one. Clean it a little bit with it. See, it helped you a lot right there just with the steel. And we'll polish it up real good with the brass. I have to go different directions, circular. I'm not going to get them perfect. I might hit that a little bit with the drill. And that one polished up pretty good. So you can see, there's a Sears. And that's back probably in the 40s and 50s right there. So that's mostly just the idea of it. And you see here some of these videos I'm making here that we've been digging in the rocks up there. You can see some of these is polished up pretty good. Now, when you get into some of them are just really crusty, you could take and put a little part of vinegar, white vinegar, you can get it in any household product. And then put your little salt in with it, and then let them sit for 2 or 3 minutes and take them out, rinse them off, and then do this process. But it seems to work. So I thought I'd share this with you. So look forward to some more videos. We'll probably do some better video on the oak trees up here, show you a few of them and how big they are, and a few of them, and talk about a little history on them. And then I'll have another video working on about the history of just the Kodak area in general, when it was started and why I'm finding so many shells, and I'm sure there's a lot of mini balls up here somewhere. There was some Civil War crossings down here on the river below me and stuff like that, which I like to get into later. But thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you next time.